How many people in this room are aware of that? How many people? Oh, I can see. Find the number. How many people, I'll ask again, are aware of the number of countries in Africa? Any? The number is 55. Yeah, previously we were 54, but then, no, actually we are 54. Previously we were 53, but then Sudan was divided into South Sudan and North Sudan, so we have got 54 countries altogether. Ironically, in the US you have got 50 states. However, the relationships which these countries have in Africa is very different from the relationship which the 50 states of the United States have with the general, I mean with the central government, or rather the federal government. I'm sure you're aware that the various states in Africa, I mean in the US, though having to do with different norms and values, you all have different aspects in the manner you administer the various states. Indeed, the various portfolios and responsibilities of Attorney General in each of the states is very different in the US. This difference is more emphasized when it comes to African countries. This is because the African countries are more independent from each other, more independent than the way the American states are independent from each other. I'm reliably informed that all the 54, sorry, let me just, let me start something. So in Africa, like I said, it is a big continent with several countries which translate into over 1,500 to 2,000 languages spoken across the continent of Africa. This represents a third of the world's languages. In fact, some studies indicate that the various languages in Africa are informed by the genetic diversity of the people in Africa than anyone else in the world. I am from Zambia, and my tribe is Lozi. I believe very few of you are aware of that. But Zambia is a country which is in the Central Africa with a population of about 15 million people. My team and I flew over 10,000 miles to be here with you. This translates to more or less 24 hours of flight time. Ladies and gentlemen, we deserve a medal for that. Allow me at this juncture just to introduce my colleagues from Africa. That is from Kenya, South Africa, and Nigeria, who have equally traveled a long distance to come and be with us today. From South Africa, we have the National Director of Public Prosecutions, Mr. Sean Abrahams. Please, may you stand so I can be welcome.